walk up to women, approach them, enjoy them, but never look for women to give you self-worth as a man. Excuse me. I'm stopping you.
Okay.
Are you a bit sick?
Yeah.
Okay, so I can whisper with you. You are a very pretty woman. So my name is Anthony. Sita? Sita, okay. It's really funny because I can't hear what you're saying.
I'm trying to...
Were you screaming last night?
No.
Okay.
Just the day before because one of my friends had a birthday party and... Yeah.
Was this unexpected for you?
You?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's get out of the sun. It's my eyes.
Yeah.
Let's stand over here. Now this is much better. Let's continue to walk because you're going this way, right?
Yeah.
Yes, I'll continue to walk with you for a little bit. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. You work for Americans. Would you live in America?
No. Or actually, maybe.
I saw your shoes when before I came up to you.
Hmm?
I said I saw your shoes before I came up to you.
Huh?
And I think your shoes will be wonderful for the kids. Because they see your shoes and they go, is it a girl? Is one of the kids a girl?
No.
Oh, it's two boys, never mind. Never mind. They're cool though, they are. I like it. In your bracelet, on your right arm. It's good. Let's sit here.
Okay.
It's so expensive, huh? Yeah.
Yep.
It's like $20 every single time to get in, like American.
So.
Do you know sign language?
No.
You don't? I don't either. Yeah, I was going to say we can do sign language, but I don't know it. I was going to tell you to teach me sign language.
That would be funny.
If we went from like talking to like...
So what did you do around here? Just go meet someone?
Yeah. Take a walk. You know, this is the last time the weather is going to be like this. You know, it's going to just progressively go down. So enjoy these last days of good weather.
Yeah.
Are you a summer or a winter person?
I guess autumn and spring. Kind of spring. Summer, it just...
Yes. These glasses look great for your face. So you like disco? You don't like disco? Your friend invited you, so you were there, but you didn't like it.
It's not my place. I hate that loud music.
You hate techno music?
No, not techno. That loud music.
Oh, that loud music.
Yeah, it's too loud, so we have to scream to each other to be understood.
Hello.
I'm going to the bathroom. What? I'm going to the bathroom.
Yes. No.
Yo!
Oh, you speak some Hungarian?
Just some small words. I can use the expressions like yo and igen and them. I'm going to go back in the center. So, are you? You want to walk this way with me, or do you want to sit here?
I have time.
My kneecap hurts. Say my knee hurts. Sometimes when I do too much on my knee, it just starts to hurt. Mm-hmm. So today I'm trying to not walk so much.
Because
I've been.
Because of the weather.
Yeah.
You are getting old and feeling your bones.
I'm getting old.
And feeling in your bones. Bad weather is coming.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
No, you weren't. You're really making fun of me. You are. You've been waiting to make fun of me. It was just your perfect opportunity.
Actually, it's really hard in English. I am so much better in Hungarian English.
So you're trying to tell me that your ability to make fun of someone, now you're bragging because you're like, I can make fun of you. You thought I could make fun of you in English, but imagine me in Hungarian. You don't know anything yet. Doggy, he loves it. Look at him. Hello, love.
And after she does come and ask me, hey, did you eat something? And I just, yes, I did. But I answer her in Hungarian, and then she realized that she talks to me in English.
Okay, just the knee. The knee is speaking. He's saying, sit down. My kneecap is saying, sit down, buddy. You're hurting. All of your nails are a different color. Two of them. Oh, never mind. I thought it was like all different. Is the other one on the other? Is the other one on the same thing? The same? Oh, you have a lot of interesting stuff going on.
It's from Barcelona.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm from my friends.
BSN. Barcelona. Pardon. Because you forgot my name, I get to call you one name. False faith. Okay. Oh no, I'm kidding.
No.
I'm kidding. Okay, my name is Anthony.
Anthony.
Yeah. Oh, you wasn't ready for that one, were you? You're like, I don't deserve to be called that. You know, just what you should say to him is, just look at him and go, okay, three times, okay? Because when you tell people three times, they really get it. So you go, my name is Zita. They go, okay. Say, no, say, hi, Zita. They go like, hi, Zita, and then you just do that three times. And what'll happen is it'll be good
but
for them.
He's
You deserve it this time. You do. Don't look at me like that. You absolutely do. You deserve to be called everything right now.
No, you just asked me if you said it rightly, and I just... Oranje Janusz. You wanted me to help you, so what?
Phosphate. Okay.
No.
Okay, that's enough. No more calling you names.
Okay.
No more, I'm kidding. No more calling you names.
Why did you ask what am I doing?
Because I was curious about that. Because I know that you take care of kids.
I love reading.
Okay. I now know that you love reading. I know that you are 21. I know that your friend went to Barcelona and got you a gift. Yeah. I know that you have a lot of flowers in your shoes.
Yeah.
I know that you don't like loud clubs.
Yeah.
And that probably means that you like more relaxed environments than you do chaotic environments. So you would hate probably if this whole city was filled with people, but you would love if this was a park and there was nature.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Good job.
Now, the breakdown of me.
Okay, I know that you are Anthony.
Mm-hmm.
Remember your name? you started to talk with me because you saw my bracelet and my shoes. you are good in Uno, you know just a few things in Hungarian, but almost useful.
They are very useful. Don't say that.
Yeah, phosphate.
No.
Useful.
No, I'm talking about Igen.
Igen,
them,
Yo.
And Yo, yeah, that was a very useful.
But the other is not really.
When I'm speaking to you, it's very useful. One of the things mainly that a man is looking for when he walks up to a woman is the confirmation that he's worthy. No longer is it a woman that he wants to speak to. It becomes a situation for him to become okay with himself. A situation for him to go, if this woman gives me a good response, that means that I'm worthy. If this woman is able to receive me, that means that it's confirmed. I am worthy. That confirmation that a man looks for through his whole life is mainly one of the things that robs him of his experience of living. You can't truly enjoy a woman when you're in front of her if you're always looking for moment to moment the confirmation that you're worthy of her. Because different behaviors will come out. This is why guys, they walk up to women and they start to speak too much. They never allow a chance for there to be space. Because in the space, something may arise that they don't want to arise. Everything is going smoothly. Everything is flowing. There's no chance for there to be a sense of unworthiness here. Because the moment a man feels that he's uncomfortable, the feelings of unworthiness start to show up. Because he starts to feel, take the uncomfortableness and turn it into something. He turns it into, this means that I'm not enough for this woman. This means that this woman is too much for me. This means that I need to be more confident to be able to be around women like this. Always he's looking for the next moment of confirmation. And any moment that's not of confirmation, he then sees it as, I have to do something so I can get that. Approach women. I will say do it. Approach women. See a woman walking down the street and enjoy the process of going over to her. Enjoy it. But never look for a woman to make you feel worthy, because she can't make you feel worthy ever. Worthiness is not induced from a person saying you're worthy. Worthiness is induced by you going up and allowing yourself the chance to do that which you want to do. That's where true worthiness comes from. Because worthiness doesn't need to be even confirmed. But when you go up and you do something that you want to do, in that moment, you're letting yourself know that you're willing to do whatever you want. That's more important than worthiness. Worthiness is something that's made up. In the same way I told you guys, confidence is something that's made up, worthiness is as well. Guys go, I'm not enough. And I go, you're not enough simply because you haven't went over there and show the woman that you're enough. That's why. Because not enough is from the position of looking for confirmation that you are enough. And when the confirmation is not there, guess what happens? You're not enough. But if I told that same guy to walk up to the woman, and I only want you to focus on enjoying your time being there with her, that's it. Just focus on that. Just focus on being there with the woman and enjoying your time with her. find out who she is as a woman. Enjoy her presence. Enjoy what it's like to be around this feminine flavor that's different than every feminine flavor in the world. Enjoy your time being with her. Just be totally there. The moment I tell the guy to do that, he goes up, and then when he comes back, I go, tell me, were you worthy of that woman? Now he's confused. And that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to confuse him simply because until a person becomes confused about what it is, they'll always hold on to, I need to become worthy. But you need to become confused about it for clarity to show. Which means you need to do something that alters that. You need to do something in opposition to that. Because once you do something in opposition of it, now there's tension, there's confusion in the middle. Now, as there's confusion, something needs to be clear. Going up to the woman and saying hello to her, giving her a compliment, this starts to clear up the confusion. This starts to clear up what it means to be worthy. But the woman herself is not giving you the worthiness you need. This is a heavy, heavy insight that I have to come to, and this is something that I want you guys to flow with. I don't care if you believe me or not. Your belief in this does not matter to me. It's only giving you the chance to see clearly. Enjoy your time with women. That's the only thing you literally can do when you walk up to a woman, is enjoy your time with her. That's it. Anything other than that is you trying to confirm something within yourself. And men constantly do this. They walk up to the woman. They see her, she's beautiful, and they go. And as they're walking up to her, they're starting to scan about how beautiful she is. Because the more beautiful she is, the more confirmation they're gonna feel that they're enough. That's crazy that when the beauty goes up, the stakes of am I worthy enough goes up as well. So he goes there, and what's at stake is, if this girl rejects me, I'm not worthy. That's at stake. So he goes up, and sometimes he's a little bit on the back foot. So he doesn't fully commit. Because he doesn't want to be giving that reality that he's trying to look, not what that he's trying to avoid, that he's not worthy enough. He's trying to avoid that reality even as he's going to go talk to a woman in a moment. So there's tension there. So he goes up maybe half like, hello, and the girl's like, and she feels that there's an energy there that is ambiguous. There's an energy there that's completely unclear to her. And when that unclear energy is there to her, a lot of times it'll put her into a reaction because she's like, what's going on? That's what's happening. And then as that what's going on is happening, the guy's there. And now she's feeling, okay, this is a guy that's trying to get something from me. That's the immediately that she feels. I don't care if she feels that that is a sales guy, a guy trying to get her attention because he likes her. Doesn't matter. She feels that there's get energy there, which energy that's trying to take. And you've heard many people talk about this, but that's the energy that she's feeling in that moment. There's a taking energy. And as she's feeling that, you're trying to take something, which you are. You're trying to take from her the confirmation that you are enough. Then immediately she goes, boom, or she goes, I'm going to go. And she gets out of there. That's the thing that he's absolutely trying to avoid, and he manifests it because he walks up and he's on the back foot. So he manifests the very thing that he's afraid of, which is he's not worthy enough for her. And he'll continuously manifest that with every woman he walk up to, after woman, after woman, and after woman, to the point where he goes, I'm not worthy of beautiful women. Or even before he even tries, he goes, that woman, I'm not worthy of her. I don't want to go up and have that reality shown to me, so I'd rather not do it at all. That's the worst place for a man to be in, because that's just a place of total self-sabotage, because he's just always talking down to himself, to this person that he doesn't even know. Women can only give you the chance to enjoy them. That's it. But your worth as a man comes from you going up to the woman and just saying something to her, going up to her with intention and allowing yourself to be there. This is the only thing. Worth in itself is not something to move toward. You're already worthy. The moment you go up looking for the confirmation for it, you will never get it. Never. Every man who's became worthy, so to speak, became worthy or is talking about they're worthy of women now, every guy who became that or who said they became that, they didn't become that. They already were that, but they let go of their need to look for that. That's what it is. Now they can enjoy women more. When I walk up to women, they don't have to worry about if she's going to respond good to them. They don't have to worry about if I say this thing right here, will this woman receive it well? They don't have to worry about this thing simply because they've let go of the woman and what her responses mean to them. For me, I remember guys walking up to women and getting responses and trying to gauge whether or not I'm worthy enough yet. And the same way where the beauty goes up, for me, it was the same thing. When the beauty went up, immediately I became more uncomfortable. It became much more at stake. Will I be worthy enough? Will I be able to stand the ground with this woman? It was just me versus. That's what it was. Me versus the woman. And many of the times, that never ended up in the right position because I was always challenging the woman. That was for me specifically. Because I felt like I was less, so I always tried to challenge so that she could become, so to speak, to where I was. That doesn't work either. But what absolutely does work is understanding right now from the position where you are at that no woman you walk up to will make you feel worthy. A woman can encourage you. She can. Even a woman you're with right now, let's say you're with a woman right now, she can encourage you. She can make you feel better. A woman can let you know that you have something amazing inside of you. That's what she can do. But she can never give you worth. Never. Because like I told you, worth is made up. She can never give you worth, but she can always encourage you. Many men, they look for that moment when they walk up to a girl and the girl goes, "You made my day." Or, "You're confident." They love these moments because these moments confirm to them something. It either confirms to them, yeah, I am worthy, or confirms to them, yeah, I am confident, or confirms to them, yeah, I do make Women's Day. And they want just some ground so they can know that they're worthy. Allow women to do these things. But what about the women you walk up to who go, no, or sorry, I'm not interested, or this is weird, and walk off, or just blank you? What about those women? Can you allow that same type of response to let you know that you shouldn't look for worth? As much as encouragement teaches you, what teaches you even more is the times where you're not getting encouraged. Because when you're not getting encouraged, you find the truth of yourself. You're in front of the woman, and you're trying to get something back for her, and she just gives you a harsh response. Let that response teach you that to stop looking for worth when you walk up to women. Stop looking for it, because they will never give you that. Women will never give you the worth that you're looking for as a man. They can only encourage you. They can only say things to you based on the way that they feel. That's it. Even a man can't give you worth. He can't. We can be influenced by his presence. We can be influenced by his depth of substance. But the worth is really found by you allowing yourself to throw out worth and just go do the thing you want to do. In the same way I said throw out confidence and go do what you want, throw out worth, because worth comes when you express that which you want. That's when you really feel, so to speak, worthy. When you express that which you want to express. Because as you express it, maybe you feel nervous as you're doing it, but at least the energy is leaving. At least you are unlocking more energy within yourself for you to be able to do this thing that you want to do. Approach and enjoy women. Enjoy. Enjoy what it's like to be around a woman. Enjoy what it's like to be in front of a woman and look her in the eyes. Enjoy what it's like to sit next to her and to have her be nervous and to have her sometimes not know what to say and be a little bit feel awkward. Enjoy these moments with a woman where she's looking at you and she feels attracted to you. Enjoy, enjoy, enjoy. But let go of the part where you're looking for the woman to give you worth, where you're looking for the woman's response to let you know that you're worthy as a man, that you're looking for a woman's eyes, her body, her posture, the way that she's reacting to you to let you know something about you. This is the part now where you have to move toward letting go. Okay, what where is it at?
1521.
Okay. And as you move towards just let go, you start to notice that not only is it enjoyable to talk to women, but the worth that I was looking for, it was coming from the fact that I was fully there and I was enjoying the woman. That's worth. That's true worth. Worth is showing up fully as you are. That's worth. Because I told you, you're already worthy as a man. So when you show up fully here, you're worthy. You're not worthy when you are there, but simultaneously on the back foot. You're not worthy when you're there with the woman, but as you're there, you're constantly feeling in your mind, okay, should I say this? Okay, should I do this? Should I talk like this because she's beautiful? Should I show disinterest? When you're doing all these things, of course, you're feeling unworthy. Of course you are. Because there's a lot of reactions going on inside of you. And the way you're interpreting these reactions is that this means I'm not worthy of this woman. And that automatically puts you on the back foot. And on the back foot, what do? You talk too much. You nervously speak. You constantly fill in the silences. It's hard for you to stand still. All these are manifestations of you just feeling like you're unworthy of the person you're in front of. That's what it is. This is why I say to feel the most worthy when you're in front of somebody is to show up fully as you are. There's no need for you to try to psych yourself into something. Just fully be there with the woman, because when you're fully there, it's fully you. Who you are is valuable for that which you want in life and in relation to women. It's just realizing it. That's the realizing in the moment. When you show up fully, that's the realizing. Because when you stay in the midst of all that chaos happening on the inside of you, you start to notice that you are always worthy. You are always valuable for what you want. You always have the value for what you want. The realizing happens when you stay in the midst. When you're there and you go, I'm enjoying this woman right now, but I want to walk away because I'm scared. That's when a realization shows up. It shows up because in that moment when you're scared, you still express yourself. And as you express yourself, you notice that it can lead somewhere, because the woman may even notice you're nervous, but because you're still there and you're fully there. Maybe you say, you know what, later on tonight, let's have a drink. And she goes, I can't do tonight, but I can do tomorrow. And the moment you walk away, you start to feel something different. Because you stood in the midst of that which you felt was unworthy. And as you stood there, you showed that you were worthy. That's the fucking difference. That you stood there in the midst of it all. Of all the thoughts coming in, like, should I do this? Should I be like this? Talking fast. All these things are circling around, but you stay in the midst as you are in front of the woman. And as you do this, the worth is there. Worth is not something you attain. Worth is who you are. That's why I said, stop looking for worth. Throw it out. Not throw out yourself, but throw it out. Because the moment you throw it out as a intellectual idea, it becomes realized. I can stand in front of a woman who's in total, like, mind-blowingly beautiful. Stand right in front of her. Be scared to death. Not in as far as like sensations, because I'm not afraid of her as a woman, but her beauty may have a strong stimulus on me. And I may stand in the midst of that. And as I'm standing in the midst of that, I can still be, so to speak, normal. The reason why I can be normal is because I'm not interested in the beauty as much as I am her. The fact that I'm interested in her, I can stand in the midst of all that. And I can still do what I want, because my heart racing doesn't mean anything to me. My throat being shaky doesn't mean anything to me. My stomach churning doesn't mean anything to me. These parts of our body that close up as men when we're in front of beautiful women, that doesn't mean anything to me anymore. I just know things like this may happen. And all I'm there doing is standing in the midst of all that because I know that I'm innately worthy of anything on earth. That is why I always say, who you are is valuable for that which you want. Because in the midst of all that, who you are is valuable for that which you want. The realizing happens when you stay there. This is why I tell guys to show up fully. Because even when guys is there and he's talking to a girl, he comes up and he's like, hi, and he's like doing this thing. I'm like, bro, stop bouncing. You don't want to bounce. You're bouncing because you're trying to avoid what's happening on the inside or what could happen. But stand fully in the midst of what you're afraid of, fully. And just stay there. Talk to the woman, express that which you feel to be true moment to moment. Express what you want. You want to know her this moment. You like the way she looks, that's okay. Express the fact that right now, you want to walk this way. As you guys noticed in the video, I just start walking with the woman. Boom, let's sit down here. I want to do these things, but I don't have to figure out, is this worth or not? I can just stand there in front of the woman, be totally here, worthy as I am. There's nothing more worthy than me being totally here. Nothing. I can try out all type of behaviors that I want. Guys, they try out so many different things, so many. They try out acting like this. They try out being like this. They try out looking like this. They try out speaking like this. They try out behavior after behavior after behavior after behavior, but nothing will give them more worth than just standing there in front of a woman totally. There's nothing more worthy than that. That's why I tell you guys that the most valuable thing to a woman coming from a man is his total presence. When he's totally present, she gets to feel him. She's not getting kind of him. She's not getting some of him. She's getting all of him in that one moment. This is why I express to guys more than anything when I'm coaching them, silence. Because when a man's in silence, he's the most realized. When he's speaking, he's the less realized that he's going to be. When he's in silence, he's the most realized he will ever be. Because that is the thing people run away from their whole life, is moments of silence. But moments of silence is moments of truth. You want to know who you are? Stand fully there in front of somebody and be totally silent. Watch all the manifestations of you try to come up to distract you from that which you are. The egotistical reactions. Who you are is valuable for that which you want, guys. Just realizing it. Please, when you're in front of women, just allow yourself to be there with them, to give them you. That's worth. Nothing more than that is worth. So express that. Express what you want. Within that space, allow yourself to express what you want. And in doing this, what you'll notice is women respond to you much differently. They responded to me much differently when I stopped trying to go up to them and be something. When I went up to women and I was like, okay, I'm going to focus on just being there with her. Moment to moment, I'll be spontaneous. I'll allow myself to express what I want. When I feel this, I'll say this. One guy wrote me a message. He said, Tony, when I see you out there talking to girls, you don't look like a pickup artist. And I said, and I was just feeling like I know. Because she's getting me. She's not getting something I'm trying to be. She's getting me. That's what you guys want. You want women to get you, not anything else. And when I started to do that, I started to push more women away who didn't want me. And the women who did want me, they really wanted to see me again. And that's what I want for you guys. I don't want you to be out there trying to just get every single woman because you're trying to be like this and act like this and do this and this girl likes it done this way. Of course, that's up to you, but that's not, of course, what I endorse. I endorse you being totally as you are and allowing that to attract women, because guess what? That's going to attract women more than anything that you're going to be anyway. The women who are best for you. Thank you guys for tuning in to this video. because this gave you everything that you needed to know about worth in relation to women. That women can be enjoyable, but they can never give you the worth that you're looking for. The moment you split yourself, cut yourself from the confirmation is realized. I have a free Meet the Bedroom series, guys. Did you know that? And the link below is totally free for you. If you go to the link below and it'll take you to the website, you put in your little details and you'll be able to get that plus more exclusive content. Also, to let you guys know, I'm coming to America. Toronto, Canada, New York City, San Francisco, here I come. And all of you guys who are close to that, I advise you to stay tuned for those dates. And there's a lot of cool shit that's happening with this seminar, because it's unlike any pickup seminar that you'll see out there, and it's much more than pickup. And like I always say, who you are is valuable for that which you want in life and in relation to women. It's just realizing it. I'll see you guys in the next video.